You're with a small group of students who seem to be mounting what seems like a symbolic blockade. Tell us what's going on around you and what they're hoping to achieve.
That's right. We're actually only about 200 yards away from the highway that has been occupied by students now for some 4 nights. But on the other side of that, of this government compound, this is the headquarters and the office of Hong Kong's top official, a man named C.Y. Leung. And as you can see, there is, as you well put it, almost a symbolic sit-in right outside his office of several dozen of the mostly student protesters here who say they're trying to disrupt the chief executive's daily schedule here. The number of people here vastly outnumbered, I'd say, by what may be a shift change of police now arriving in buses here. The student leaders have announced that they want C.Y. Leung to step down, to resign in response to the police's use of tear gas and pepper spray against the students over the course of the weekend. That was a use of force by the security forces that seems to have angered segments of Hong Kong society and attracted more support for the protest movement, which had really only numbered a couple of thousand students before there were these confrontations over the course of last weekend. As you mentioned, the students have threatened to occupy other government offices. If they do so, they could risk losing the moral high ground that they won when the police began using force against the students, against unarmed students. That was something that won some sympathy for this protest movement. John.
It's not just that they're unarmed. It would seem, at least at a distance, that this is the calmest protest of its kind I can remember. No fiery speeches, no vandalism. And others have pointed out, and I have to ask you about it, there doesn't seem to be any garbage. There have been incredibly conscientious efforts to keep clean and recycle.
I think probably, John, it's safe to say this is probably the best behaved, politest, best mannered protest movement I've seen in my career. And you did point out the garbage pickup. The students in their kind of sit-in zone are not only collecting garbage, but they're also recycling, separating cardboard from plastics and metals and trying to keep the area clean. As we see in many of these kind of protest movements around the world, an explosion of art, references to lyrics from artists like John Lennon, to local bands like the band Beyond, whose songs become anthems here, and a lot of idealism as well, with people talking about reminding followers not to use force, that this is a nonviolent civil disobedience movement, and of course the main demand: democracy, democracy, democracy. People want democratic elections for their top official in 2017. They say these are basic rights that they should get. Of course, the Chinese government, the Hong Kong government, have called this entire movement illegal.